All right, so in this program, we're going to look at how to add our random number generator to our dice game and get it working. So down here in code blocks, we've got our dice game. It's the really rough one that we did the very last video. So right now, everything is just a roll value of 4. Let's build a dice class. This is going to do a couple of things. One is it's going to take all the code that we're using for generating the pseudo-random numbers and kind of group it all together. So if we ever wanted to replace that routine with something else, that would make it easy to make that change. And then the other thing is we might want to make a bunch of different dice games after this. If we could put this into a dice class, then that would really help us with code reusability later. So let's think about what we would want out of a programmed dice. So we really just want to be able to create the dice. So to be able to create the dice, we need to initialize the random number generator. And then we also need to determine how many sides the dice is going to have. So typically a die would be a 6-sided die. But if you were doing something where you needed, you know, fancier stuff like 10-sided or 18-sided die or something like that, let's just go ahead and give this the functionality. We won't need it for the game pig, but it's easy to add it in here. And then the other thing that it'll need to do is return the random number generator. It'll need to use the random number generator and then return a value that's somewhere between 1 and the number of sides of the dice. And then in terms of our private variables, we could keep sides stored as a private variable. And then we could also keep the last roll stored as a private variable. So let's go ahead and build the dice class. I'm just going to build it right up here since this is a fairly small program. So we want to be below the include statements, but above main. I'm just going to call it class dice. And then remember, when you're doing a prototype, it has a semicolon after it. So we'll start off with the private, and then we'll have the public. Under private, we'll use that for our variables. So sides would be an integer. And then last roll would be an integer. Why don't we just call it roll? Then under public, we want the functionality so that our program can interact with it. If you put the member functions under private, then the main wouldn't be able to interact with your class. So the first one would be our constructor. Let's do a default constructor. And with our default constructor, let's set the sides to be 6. And then let's use a parameterized constructor to set the number of sides. So sides would be an integer. So we'll do with our constructors have to be the same name as our class. So it's class dice. So these have to be dice. Default constructors always avoid. And then your parameterized constructor, you can list however many variable types or class types you want in there. We just need the one integer. All right, and then the last thing we need is just to return that random roll value. So we already used roll here. So why don't we do a roll die for this one. And let's think about this with the roll die. We don't need to send it anything, so it would be a void because we're not sending it anything. But it's returning an integer, so we need to have integer in front. So we've got our dice prototype here. Now let's work on our enabling codes. Now I'm going to go ahead and just maximize the program. So to enable it, you could enable it right in the class prototype, but that makes your class prototype fairly large. So let's enable it down here. Let's just go ahead and compile it though and make sure I don't have any syntax errors in there. Okay, looks good. I'm always going to recommend that you type in a few lines of code and then go ahead and try and compile, build and run, or compile and run, just to make for sure that you're not generating a lot of errors. If there's an error, I know it's confined to this little block of code that I just typed in. All right, so let's enable our constructor. So it's the member function dice is our constructor, and then it belongs to dice, so it would be dice colon colon dice. So think of the class as the last name, and think of the name here kind of as your first name, and it's always last name, first name. So we need to set the number of sides. So this is our default, so we're going to use 6. Sides is our private value that we already have up here. Now we need to build in all that stuff from the random number generator. So we need to include a C standard library. And let's also include C time. So we don't want to start generating random numbers yet, but we do want to seed the random number generator. That was the same line that we had in the previous program. So we've got a little bit typed in. Let's run it. Okay, so it's working. Now we need to do the parameterized constructor. So I'm going to just copy the default constructor and just paste it down here. And we'll make whatever changes we need. So we're going to do an integer. So this is going to change to an integer. And I can't call it sides because sides is already declared up there. So I'm just going to call it S. And then down here, instead of sides is equal to 6, we'll do sides is equal to S. So now we've set the number of sides in both of our constructors. Now we're ready to start rolling the dice. So let's do the last member function here. So it's returning a type int. So int goes first. And then we do dice colon colon roll underscore die. And then you could just leave it blank or put the void in front. Notice with all these, we don't have a semicolon here because these are not prototypes. These are the enabling code that goes inside the function. So with this one, and again, you'll notice class dice is like your last name. So the last name goes first. And then there's your first name is the name of the function roll underscore die. You have to put the int, though, out in front because that's what's being returned. So we've already set the number of sides, so we just need to get a roll value. Get that pop-up down. So we're going to do std colon colon rand open close parentheses, so that'll run the random number generator starting from whatever this time and give us the next number in the sequence. We're going to do that modulus, so that's the percent sign, and then we're going to do sides because we already set sides up there, and then we'll do a plus one. Now if this bothers you that all this is on the line here, we can go ahead and put parentheses around it, maybe make it a little bit more readable, and then put a semicolon. It'd be a good idea to go back and just kind of comment some of this stuff. So let's put this. And let's comment this guy. Now, had we missed one little portion of this because we said that we were going to store that roll value. So why don't we do that? Why don't we change this to roll equals? Move this up. And then we'll do a return roll. We don't really have a functionality to use roll, but if you wanted to expand this and get the previous value without having to roll the dice again, that might be a good functionality to have. So let's just go ahead and build that little bit of flexibility in here just in case we want to use it again. Okay, so now before we're doing anything with this in main, let's just try and build and run it again. Okay, everything seems to be working. So let's go down in main and look at how to implement this in main. So we've got all of our declaration statements here, and then we're starting with the input output. So there's no reason that this input output's going to affect the number of sides or anything. We're not asking the user to type in the number of sides. So we can go ahead and declare an instance of this class just right here, kind of in our declaration block. So this is class dice, so we'll do dice, and then whatever you want to call it in your program. And we can do it one of two ways. One way would be we could do the name with no parentheses. That's going to use the default constructor. Or you could send it the number of sides. So you could do like that. That would use the parameterized constructor. So either way is fine. This one, I'm just going to go ahead and keep it really simple. We'll just use the parameterized, sorry, the default constructor. Let's run it again. Okay, it's still working. Now we can go down here to roll value. And we've got roll value equals 4. So let's take this out. Let's take this comment out because now we fixed it. So to use this, we need to give it the name of the instance, my underscore die, and then do a period to indicate that you're going to use a variable or a function that belongs to it. There's your roll die. You have to still do open close parentheses so that C++ recognizes it that it's a function that you're using, a member function that you're using out of the class, that you're not just trying to use a variable. Okay, and then let's go ahead and replace that same statement everywhere we see this. We're going to replace this with roll value. Looks like that was it for the player. And then we need to do this also for the computer. Okay, I think we got it. So now let's run it again and see if we're getting some different numbers when we run it. Okay, so we rolled a 2. Do we want to roll again? Yes. We rolled a 2. Let's roll again. We rolled a 2. Let's roll again. Okay, and then that was a little bit scary that we rolled 3 2s right in a row, but you can see that we're rolling 1s and 5s as well. So let's go ahead and close it down. So at this point now you've got the dice going in there, and so you'd want to go back to your main. Play it a few times and make for sure that your logic structure and your control structure is still working now that you've integrated the class into it. And there's always the potential that you'll need to add something to it or modify your control structure as you go. But now you should have a pig program now that has a working main, or at least a mostly working main. And then you've got your dice class that's implemented. And the next video, we'll talk about how to do a player class, which will take care of the scorecard, and also give you another set of code that you could reuse for any kind of game where you have to have a scorecard. So a card game, a dice game, any of those kind of things. So thanks for watching.